Hello, everyone. Welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host for today, Tabitha Moretto. Our guest today is Dr. Jeremy Cumpston, who has been a general practitioner for some 28 years. He has a special interest in anti-aging and men's health and has worked in the past as a men's health physician. Today, we're going to talk about something interesting, something called NAD+, a compound that helps those struggling with addiction and mental health issues. Without further ado, welcome to the show, Jeremy. It's very nice to have you here.
Thank you, Tabitha. It's nice to be here too.
Yes, my pleasure. So, Jeremy, please tell the audience more about yourself and the nature of your work.
Okay, so I guess, as you stated, I've been a general practitioner for a life sentence of 28 years so far. I've always had a keen interest in just, I don't know, I guess in anti-aging and how the body ages. And I've always had a very keen mind as to why. Why does this have to happen? Why do we have to? You know, I'm 51 now, so I wake up every morning and go, why does this have to happen to me? So I have done a lot of research over time. It's something I do at night because I've got, you know, tendencies to have my brain keep going a bit too fast, what some might say ADD. But I use research as a means of just sort of like calming my brain down, and I just enjoy it. So across along my path of working in anti-aging and men's health, on the research I've done, I came across some interesting articles about this molecule called NAD. NAD is a thing called a coenzyme. Think of it as a vitamin, and this coenzyme is really a part of every single reaction in the cell. NAD provides the energy to the energy component to the cell called the mitochondria. And when NAD levels decline, we found that the mitochondrial energy declines and, in fact, the cells die. So over time, you have NAD, this little coenzyme or vitamin in the cell, declines because of oxidative stress and life and injury. And as energy declines, the mitochondria decline, and then you get cell death. And what happens is you end up having genetic coding errors happening when you don't have enough NAD. The genome or the DNA is always under attack from oxidation and from environmental stress. And the body is really working very hard to repair that ongoing DNA damage. And NAD is absolutely, it's been found to be essential in providing the support for the little proteins that repair our DNA. Those proteins are called PARPs or CERTs, and they're both intricately linked to repairing the DNA damage that occurs every single day in all of us, in all of our cells. So we need NAD to make these PARPs and CERTs to repair our DNA, but as we get older and have increasing damage and oxidative stress, we need more and more NAD, and we actually have a declining level. So as our NAD declines, our cellular function declines, the communication within the cells declines, and the ability for our cells to repair DNA damage declines, which leads to damaged DNA coding for conditions like arthritis or diabetes or high blood pressure, cholesterol, Alzheimer's, cancer. DNA damage leads to protein synthesis problems that lead to disease states. So it's a very unhappy little story I'm telling, but basically the research has shown that the level of NAD in the body is very much correlated to the ability for the body to repair itself. And as NAD levels decline, so too does our ability to repair, and therefore we have age-related diseases that ends up the organism ends up failing.
Very interesting. Now, can you tell us, why is this relevant to health professionals?
Okay, so what has been found with NAD, and it's been found over many, many years, Tabitha. So from right down from the 1920s, NAD was discovered. And it's because NAD is a derivative of niacin, of B3. And so people that weren't getting enough vitamins, particularly B group vitamins in their diet, during the sort of depression era and in the 1920s and 30s, would often suffer from a disease state called pellagra. And that would cause, you know, terrible skin conditions, nerve degeneration, and eventual death. So what happened was is that there's a lot of experimentation on about how to actually solve this pellagra. And they found that by giving them vitamin B in their food, or giving them an IV infusion of a thing called NAD, which is a vitamin B3 derivative, would completely resolve this condition of pellagra. So they've known for a long time that NAD is essential for normal neuronal function and normal brain function. So what happened was is that when they were treating people for pellagra who also happened to be alcoholics, they found that when they were given this NAD, the desire or craving for alcohol was removed. They no longer felt the craving. And so they postulated that this NAD, this coenzyme, was also a neurotransmitter, and it had a very balancing effect on brain neurochemistry. That was taken further in the 60s in South Africa, where they started using NAD for alcoholism. And from 1960 till now, over 20,000 people have been treated using NAD in an oral capsule. And it's been a very successful treatment for alcoholism. In America, from basically the early 2000s, a clinic called the Springfield Wellness Center started using NAD in an IV solution for treating opiate addiction and alcohol addiction. And in over 2,000 people in 20 years, they've reported an 85% success rate in assisting people to become free of drugs in their life. And the way that it works is the IV NAD reduces cravings, which allows other modalities of therapy, such as, you know, intensive psychological counseling, diet, nutrition, to also work its way to reducing the behavior that led to the alcoholism or the opiate addiction. So it's been a very exciting new treatment in addiction therapy. And that's what's really, really caught my attention, is the incredible positive results they've been having using this a short-term drip of NAD to basically calm the neurological centers and improve communication, which in turn leads to a situation where people no longer have the cravings and they're able to give up whatever the substance they were addicted to.
Wow, that's amazing to know that something like NAD Plus can help all these people, especially with their condition.
So the thing is, it can't be just used on its own, though. I mean, it's an important, exciting tool, I think, to be used into physicians, psychologists, psychiatrists, nutritionists, sort of kit bag, you know, something to help people reduce the cravings so that they can actually institute other therapies to help them stop the behavior. Certainly, it's really hard to change the behavior when someone's craving something. You can't stop a craving situation just by willing it away. It doesn't happen that way. But by removing the craving, you can really, really get in there and try and adjust the behavior that has led to that addiction.
Very well said. Now, Jeremy, if you don't mind, can I ask you a personal question?
Well, it depends on what the question is, but yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Why are you so passionate about anti-aging and men's health?
Well, I don't know. There's the honest answer. I just always felt that medicine and the way that I was trained, Western medicine, seemed to be somewhat one-eyed to me. It's like, you know, you prescribe this medicine for a headache, and you prescribe this medicine for an infection, and, you know, it always seemed to me a bit ad hoc and not really well. For me, it was not really well investigated, described, explained, or quantified. I came out of med school and I was a doctor and I was seemed to be using a lot of medicines and didn't really, really go into the detail of how they were working or why they were working. And I'm not sure about whether they were actually working on the pathogenesis of the disease or the base cause of the disease. So I guess that's what started my interest in research and saying, oh, what is the cause of this situation? Like, why is it these people are getting sick? Not once they're sick will we do this. But I wanted to know why. Why are these people getting sick? And I guess that's been a lifelong sort of, it's a hobby. You know, it's something I do at night and I read about things. And with regards to finding out about the NAD, I mean, it came to me from someone saying, there's this amazing brain boost treatment in Harley Street. My friend had been there and he said, it was amazing. I felt so clear. I felt so calm. I was able to get things done. I think you should really investigate it. So I looked at it from a point of view that if someone I really trusted, this is a very close friend of mine, also a medico, said that this treatment really worked for him. And I didn't feel he would be sucked into the placebo effect. So I started to investigate and saw that, yes, there's a very big business in Europe and America for using this as a brain boost. But what I really found was that the most important research on the topic of NAD and its its relation to oxidative stress in the body, and which is really about how the body copes with stress and aging and what happens to our DNA as we age. All this incredible research was actually coming out of Sydney, Australia, down the road from me, by an individual called Dr. Ross Grant. And he's literally put 20 years of intense research into this molecule. And I think it's really starting to show that his research is going to pay massive dividends in terms of how we deal with certain conditions, particularly those that are related to neurochemical disorders in humans.
Thank you very much, Jeremy, for sharing your story about your passion for medicine, anti-aging, and all of the above.
Thank you very much, Tabitha, and thanks for having us.
Yes, my pleasure. Unfortunately, Jeremy, we only have a little time left, but before we go, what is your main takeaway message to all of our listeners out there? What would you like to tell them?
The main takeaway message is that I would like them to have a look at NAD, the work of Ross Grant, and if they have people, loved ones, who are having problems with addiction, be it opiate, methamphetamine, or alcohol, then they should look at the potential of NAD IV therapy to assist in getting those people back into a more sober, healthy life. I think that we're going to be doing research on measuring NAD levels in all the patients we treat, and we're sending that back to Dr. Grant. So I'm quite excited by the potential for NAD to be a helpful adjunctive tool in treating, you know, mental illness and addiction.
Excellent message, Jeremy. And one more question. For those who want to get in touch with you, how can they do that?
Okay, so the best way to probably get in touch is just to send us an email to go to our website, which is www.agelessnad, that's agelessnad.com.au, and send us an email, and I'll promise that I'll personally respond to it.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Jeremy, for coming on the show. It was a pleasure having you.
Thank you very much, Tabitha. I really appreciate it.
And that was Jeremy Cumpston. We just had a fascinating conversation about NAD+. A compound found in every cell in your body that plays a vital role in regulating how quickly your cells age. If you like this interview, transcripts and archives are available at www.hpr.fm. We're on all social media platforms, so don't forget to follow, like, and subscribe. We're also available for download on SoundCloud and iTunes. I'm Tabitha Moretto, and you're listening to Health Professional Radio.